So now, with a little bit of foreshadowing, let me introduce our next speaker, Professor Asu Ozdaglar. Professor Ozdaglar is the head of the MIT Electrical Engineering and Computer Science Department here at MIT. She first joined the faculty in 2003 as an assistant professor before continuing on as an associate professor, a tenured professor, and her current position as the head of EECS. She earned her bachelor's from Middle East Technical University in Turkey and her PhD from MIT. Professor Ozdaglar's research focuses on technical and societal aspects of large-scale data-driven systems. In 2011, she was selected as a Kavli Fellow of the National Academy of Sciences. Her expertise includes optimization, machine learning, economics, and networks. In addition to her academic role, she serves as the Deputy Dean of Academics for the Schwarzman College of Computing at MIT. Please welcome Professor Ozdaglar.
Hi, hello, everyone. My name is Asu Ozdaglar, but I like the Dr. Oz as well very much. As Nitya mentioned, I'm the head of Department of Electrical Engineering and Computer Science at MIT, the largest department at MIT with almost 50% of the students, which is a big, big department. And I'm very delighted to kick off the award ceremony for the 2022 Math Prize for Girls. This fantastic contest, like all great events, has a dedicated team of people who make it happen. I want to thank, as everyone, the Advantage Testing Foundation, including its president, Arun Alagappan, for founding this important prize and serving as its main sponsor for the last 13 years. And also Ravi Bopanna, the director of this contest, for having me here be part of this amazing event. Thanks also to Jane Street, including Shandor Lehoski and Kristin Chang, for its transformative endowment of the Math Prize and for becoming a co-sponsor. Finally, I'm also grateful to everyone at MIT who helped make this event successful, such as the admissions office, math department, 50 students who hosted contestants in their dorm rooms, and the 60 students who volunteered to help the Math Prize run smoothly. So on behalf of all of these people, I'm here to say once again, welcome to MIT. If you got a little chill hearing that phrase, believe me, I still feel a chill saying it after all these years I have been at MIT and I have been here for a few. The thrill never really goes away because MIT is famous throughout the world as the very epicenter of math and science and engineering, the place where brilliant, hardworking people from every continent gather to work on the thorniest puzzles the universe has to offer. As of today, that group of brilliant, hardworking people includes you. You're all here because you've discovered the special joy of working on a problem which does not immediately solve itself, which does not reveal all answers right away. A really good math problem is like a walled and secret garden. Many people walking around outside never attempt to glimpse at the other side of what seems to be a high brick wall. It seems too hard, too confusing, and even frustrating. Worst of all, many students are told that the garden of math is not for them, that they're not the right kind of person to succeed at math. We know that more girls are given this message than boys, and that too many girls become discouraged as a result, never discovering the beauty, sense, and symmetry, and as Shandor mentioned, all this magic, which only those with the curiosity to find the gate and the patience to try many keys can discover. You have found that gate and discovered the wonderful feeling of reward, which happens when you find the correct key to open the world of math. I use math every day in my career, and I can tell you, that feeling literally never goes away. Solving a difficult puzzle, I mentioned, is one of the purest joys there is. It's like creating music. But just as an entire orchestra of musicians can create harmonies beyond the ability of one player, an entire team of mathematicians can find solutions far beyond the capabilities of a single person. This the myth of the lone genius toiling away without help or collaboration, having a single moment of inspiration that single-handedly reveals a great universal truth is just that, a myth. And here's the truth. Science happens in teams, groups of people all working on parts of the puzzle, trying to solve something much bigger than themselves. I'd like to give you an example. One of those teams here at MIT included a 29-year-old woman, computer scientist, Katie Booman. Katie was a graduate student in my department, Electrical Engineering and Computer Science, when she led the creation of a new algorithm to produce the first ever image of a black hole. The effort to capture the image using telescopes from all around the world in locations ranging from Antarctica to Chile involved a team of more than 200 scientists. No one of us could have done it alone, Katie said to CNN. It came together because of lots of different people from many different backgrounds. I want to say that again, lots of different people from many different backgrounds. It took a big group of people to take the first image of a black hole, and it's going to take many others to solve the biggest problems facing our world today. It's going to take all of us to solve climate change, to rid the world's oceans of plastic pollution, to cure diseases like malaria, to eliminate hunger and inequality in all the places we find it. There are so many problems to keep all of us very, very busy. And we know that math, science, and computation are the keys we need to solve those problems. And that means we can't afford to leave anyone outside math's walls, feeling like it's too hard or too frustrating, or like they aren't the right person to be good at math. We need everyone to realize that math is amazing and beautiful, and this is important, I think, above all, fun. And they have the potential to be good at it, and we will help. We need to be gate openers, not gatekeepers. Here at MIT, within my department, we've been working very hard to bring more women into the world of math, computation, and engineering. And the good news is that our efforts are paying off. I'm very delighted to share with you that just this last year, we welcomed a record number of women into our graduate program, PhD program, highest in the history of the department. Next year, we hope to break that record yet again. But there's still much more to do, not only here at MIT, but all around the world. And that brings me to my challenge for you today. When you go back to your schools and your hometowns, I want you to invite more people into this community to show them how much fun math can be. I want you all to discover the thrill of saying, "Welcome to MIT." Because the truth is, the spirit of MIT is everywhere and anywhere that people gather together to work hard at using math and science to improve their world. When we say welcome to MIT, what we're really saying is, in a way, welcome to math, welcome to science, this is a place for you. You have all discovered in your own schools and your own communities that there's a great reward in this work, not just a big cash prize, but the chance to work at something bigger than yourself, with a team of friends, having fun while you solve the world's toughest problems. I'll say it again, having fun with a big team of friends solving hard problems. That's the only key you need. Welcome to the amazing world it unlocks. I hope you enjoy your day at MIT, and thank you.